tonight with a game called Scenes from a Hat. It's for all four contestants. You'll have to come on down. This is the hat. Into it have been put a number of suggestions made by the studio audience for little scenes the contestants might like to act out. And I'll just pull them out and buzz when I get the idea of it. A lot of points over there. And so here we go. It's the first suggestion. If our eyes were somewhere else on our bodies.
Excuse me, I've got something on my eye. Could you get it out?
Hang on.
Practical Joking International Share Dealers.
So, that's a deal then. Ha ha!
Worrying things to be given on a plane. Worrying things to be given on a plane.
Hello. Here's the engine.
Thank you.
Life's big disappointments.
Oh, so you're Tony Slattery.
Well, he's no more disappointing in real life than he is on the telly, I don't...
Shut
Designing
up.
The first human.
I think the eyes are in the wrong place.
I know!
Faux pas at a christening. Several faux pas.
I name this child Satan. Stan! Stan!
Okay, monsters that aren't scary. Okay, let's end there. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, Tony and Steve, come on down for Film and Theatre Stars. Give you your scene in just a moment. Some Film and Theatre Stars for these two, please.
Tom and Jerry.
Tom and Jerry, yes, I can see why you might think that.
Carry on.
Yes?
Hammer Horror.
Hammer Horror, always
big
a good
movie.
One.
Oscar
Which movie?
B.
B, all right.
Medieval Mystery Play.
Medieval Mystery Play, that's a good one.
Restoration Comedy.
Restoration Comedy. One more, what was that? Little House on the Prairies.
Prairie.
Yeah. Is it already? Not with the time this is transmitted. Now, what's your scene? Steve, you're leading a mutiny on Tony's ship.
Right. Captain, I've had a word with the men.
Have you? What did they say?
Well, we don't think you're sailing this ship right.
Don't you tell me what to do.
It's all them frills you had us put on the sails. We didn't like them.
Why not?
Well, it sort of slows us down round the Cape of Good Hope.
Cape of Good what?
You are, Captain.
You'd be lucky.
They don't call you Captain Hornblower for nothing, do they? That's what we don't like.
You swab the bloody dicks.
We found biscuits in the maggots.
I know.
That ain't right. At all.
Which county do you come from? It's changing. Moment to moment.
Hard astern! And a bit soft round the front.
Thank you.
I hardly like to interrupt, but... and I don't think I'm going to change it much. Medieval Mystery Play.
Where's the crew? I don't know, it's a mystery.
Why, of course, it's the Mary Celeste. What do you expect? But surely, if our Lord is to be graced in this noble year of 1222, the men shall surely take prayer and throw you overboard as you cast adrift.
Bitch.
That's not that
well. You've evidently never seen a medieval mystery play. Or if you have, you're not going to recreate it for us. Well, why don't you do a Hammer Horror?
Seasick.
Oh, that's horrible.
That's coming back. No, 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 no.
It's the vomit.
Do a bit of Carry On combined with a Jacobean tragedy.
I'll tell you what, before.
Yeah. I've been up on the poop deck. That's disgusting.
I'll tell you, bend over and swab that. Go on.
Oh, yeah, have you seen my figurehead?
Go on, bend over.
Yeah, what's going on below decks? Go on, tell
me. Have a look. Ooh,
yeah. Okay, listen, thank you very much. Thank you. Well, Now we go to a game called Who's Line. This is for Ryan and Colin, if you'd like to come on down. All they've got to do in this one is to pick up these bits of paper. Ryan, those are for you, and those are for you, Colin. On the pieces of paper have been written down a couple of lines each that you have to insert into the improvisation. Just pull them out and use them, see how it goes. And the scene you're doing is pre-wedding nerves. There's two of you discussing pre-wedding nerves. I don't know if you're the groom and best
man. Nervous?
Yeah, it's my first wedding.
But it's your pre-wedding, that's why you're nervous.
I know.
If it was after wedding, it'd be post-wedding.
Look, don't give me any hassle over this, all right? I just don't know if Rebecca's the right girl.
Well, she's a bit of a tramp.
Oh, come on, man. It's not what I want to hear from you.
Well, I'm sorry that she's had more hands up her than the Muppets.
Oh, come on.
Come on! Jesus.
Look. I want to go over the vows with her. I wrote my own vows.
Well, how'd it go?
Rebecca, I love you. Stay with me always. On the whole, I prefer a dog. Or at least that style. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's nice. It's a nice thought. But when you put a dog into your wedding vows,
it's not right.
Oh, how about this? Rebecca, I love you so much. Can you smell something burning? My love for you.
What the hell is that supposed to mean? What the hell is that? Oh, you mean me?
Yes.
Oh, that might work. I don't know. I try to think of things to say to her. I remember the words of Confucius when he said, "Qing dao yan dao dong dao."
Oh yeah. Now what does that mean exactly?
Well, what it means is bad sneakers and a piñata, my friend. That's what it means.
That Confucius was pissed all the time.
I know.
That makes no sense.
I don't think it's right. I think I'm going to cancel the wedding.
Don't cancel it.
I got him, man. I mean, it's
Rebecca
just...
loves you. You love her.
I don't know.
Remember the first date you had?
Yeah.
All those many years ago.
You were there in the back seat. I remember that.
Well, I had the video camera.
You wouldn't shut up. Over and over again, you yelling out.
Oh, I hope it's on the wedding cake. Remember, I used to yell, "Does it usually throb like that?"
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Okay. It's very obvious who won that round. As we move on to a game called Foreign Film Dub, Tony and Ryan, please would you act out a film for us in a foreign language? We'll give you the language and the title of the film in a minute. Meanwhile, Steve and Colin will translate into English for us. So if you separate into those two groupings. Yes, Tony and Ryan over there. So which language would you like them to be acting out in?
Italian.
You say Italian?
Yeah.
Good. Italian's fine. So Italian. And the title of the film? Farewell, my concubine. How about, you know, not one that's already on the market? One of your own. This is free form, you know. Farewell, my porcupine. Farewell, my porcupine. Well done. Okay, farewell, my porcupine, in Italian, to be translated. Away you go.
È un pico enorme.
It's got a lot of pricks.
And so does my porcupine.
Ho.
Adorned. Alabadorned. Galabatatarn. Shikatatarn.
I don't know.
I found this porcupine in Sweden where I studied for a long time.
Ah, ti amo con tutto il cuore, lasagna mozzarella.
It's a good job I've got my asbestos gloves on.
You're right.
Infamio, infamio! Carlo, Sallo, Sallo, 1:20, pizza, 4 stagioni.
Can't you see what I'm trying to say? I love you, I love you, I love you, mad fool.
So darn. But darn, but darn. The parmesan, hell hard.
I'm sorry, but I can't return that love. I must raise these porcupines and do something with them.
A cazzo, a cazzo. He's a chef from the Muppets.
Nice haircut.
Cappuccino, halabande, lola bridge.
Huh?
Oh, I'm going to stop there. Okay.